In this video, we'll be seeing what is a right circular cone. A right circular cone is nothing but a cone, or you can say a surface generated by a straight line which passes through a fixed point and makes a constant angle with the fixed straight line which is passing through its vertex. That is, the fixed point here is known as vertex. The line which generates the surface is known as generator, and the line with which it is making an angle is known as the axis of the cone. The base is obviously a circular base, and hence it is known as a right circular cone. Suppose now you are given a cone which has a vertex, say A, alpha, beta, gamma. It has an axis which is a line given as x minus alpha upon L, y minus beta upon M equal to z minus gamma upon N, and which makes an angle, say alpha. So suppose these are the given conditions. So we know A is nothing but the vertex of the cone. Suppose AB is the axis which is given by this line. So obviously the direction ratios of the axis will be L, M and N. Now suppose there exists a point, say P, x, y, z, which is on the surface of the cone, any point on the cone. So the direction ratios of the point A, or you can say the line AP, will be x minus alpha, y minus beta, z minus gamma. Now we have here two lines, AB and AP. We know their direction ratios. So we also have a relation between the direction ratios in form of angle as cos theta equal to A1A2 B plus B1B2 plus C1C2 upon root A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square into root A2 square plus B2 square plus C2 square, where theta is the angle, A1, B1, it's C1, A2, B2, C2 are respective direction ratios. So similar, if we use this formula here, cos alpha can be written as, now here A1, B1, C1 are L, M, N, A2, B2, C2 are X minus alpha, Y minus beta, Z minus gamma. So this relation we can write it as L into X minus alpha plus M into Y minus beta plus N into Z minus gamma upon root L square plus M square plus N square into root X minus alpha square plus Y minus beta square plus z minus gamma whole square. So this relation can also be written as, or you can write it as, L into x minus alpha plus m into y minus beta plus n into z minus gamma equal to root L square, or you can shift this root term to the left hand side, so this will become whole square, equal to L square plus M square plus N square into X minus alpha square plus Y minus beta square plus Z minus gamma square multiplied by cos square alpha. Suppose this is equation 1. So this is the required equation for a right circular cone. Now this is an equation of right circular cone where vertex was some point alpha, beta, gamma, right? Now suppose we need to find an equation of a right circular cone whose vertex is at origin. Vertex origin means alpha, beta, gamma values become 0. So suppose if you substitute alpha, beta and gamma as 0 in equation 1, the relation becomes Lx plus My plus Nz whole square equal to, on the right hand side, L square plus M square plus N square into X square plus Y square plus Z square into cos square alpha, which is the required equation for a right circular cone with vertex at origin. Now suppose you have to find equation for a right circular cone whose vertex is at origin and whose axis is along Z axis. Since the axis is along Z axis, then we know the direction ratios of this line or this axis will be 0, 0, 1. That is, the direction ratios L, M will be 0 and L will, value of N will be equal to 1. So, if you substitute the direction ratios now in equation 2, the equation becomes Z square equal to L and M are 0. So, this will be 1 into X square plus Y square plus Z square into cos square alpha. Okay. So, if you observe here, this is nothing but z square plus x square plus y square into z square. Z square, which seems a common term, we can shift it to one side. So this becomes x square plus y square plus z square. If you take common, we can write it as cos square alpha minus 1 equal to 0. Or you can write it as x square plus y square equal to z square into sec square alpha minus 1. Shifting this cos to the left hand side, this will become 1 upon cos, that is sec, and x square minus 1, which we can write it as x square plus y square equal to z square into tan square alpha. So these are the three relations we've seen. First was a general equation for a right circular cone with whose vertex is some point alpha, beta, gamma, whose axis is given by some line, whose direction ratios are LM, N, and angle at some angle alpha. Now we see one of the example. So the question says, find the equation of the cone whose vertex is at point 1, 1, 3 and which passes through the ellipse 4x square plus z square equal to 1 and y equal to 4. So obviously equation of a cone whose vertex is at some point, this is the vertex, obviously the line which will be generating the cone will be at this point, one of this point. So we can write the equation of line, that is the equation of a generator which is generating the cone, as x minus 1 upon L equal to y minus 1 upon M equal to z minus 3 upon R, where L, M, N are directional ratios of this line. Okay, now this line will obviously meet the plane y equal to 4. So when it meets the y plane y equal to 4, this equation will become x minus 1 upon L equal to y, that is 4 minus 1 upon M equal to z minus 3 upon N, which can be written as x minus 1 upon L equal to 3 upon M equal to z minus 3 upon N. So if you observe, we can write values of x and z from this equation. The value of x can be written as 3 L upon M plus 1. The value of z can be written as 3 N upon M plus 3, and we have y equal to 4. So we obtain a point. Now this point can satisfy the ellipse, the given ellipse, that is 4x square plus z square equal to 1. If we substitute this point in the ellipse, it becomes 4, 3 L upon M plus 1 whole square plus 3 plus 3 N upon M whole square equal to 1. Say equation 2. Now if you observe from equation 1, we can write a relation between LM and L and MN, which we can substitute here to convert it in the form of x, y and z. So from equation 1, I can write L upon M is equal to x minus 1 upon y minus 1. And also from equation 1, I can write N upon M is equal to, z minus 3 upon y minus 1. So we have L upon N, we have N upon N. When we substitute in equation 2, we obtain, what do we obtain? 4, 3 times x minus 1 upon y minus 1 plus 1 whole square plus 3 plus 3 into n upon n, that is, n upon m, that is z minus 3 upon y minus 1 whole square equal to 1. So we can simplify this equation as 4, 3 into x minus 1 plus y minus 1 whole square upon y minus 1 whole square plus 3 times y minus 1 plus 3 into z minus 3 whole square upon y minus 1 whole square equal to 1. This y minus 1 whole square you can shift. This becomes 4 into this is 3x plus y minus 3 minus 1, that is minus 4 whole square plus, now here it is 3y plus 3z minus 3 minus 9, that is minus 12 whole square equal to y minus 1 whole square. So when you simplify this equation, if you simplify this equation, you will obtain a new equation of the form 12x square plus 4y square plus 3z square plus 6yz plus 8xy minus 32x minus 34y minus 24z plus 69 equal to 0. You have to use your a plus b plus c whole square formula to evaluate the bracket. Or you can keep it this equation as it is. So this is the required equation of the cone whose vertex is given to us as a point 1, 1, 3 and which is passing through an ellipse and a plane y equal to 4.